Okay, good morning, everyone. Today, the topic that I am going to present is about HAI Surveillance Data Validation Guidelines. So before I start my presentation, so what are these validation guidelines? So validation guidelines, they are essentially a set of instructions outlining how to ensure that data collected is accurate, complete, and reliable. So in the context of HAI or healthcare associated infection surveillance, these guidelines provide a framework for verifying the information gathered on hospital acquired or healthcare acquired infections. So how do I simply explain this? So for example, you want to bake a cake. So imagine you are baking a chocolate cake. So the recipe will serve as guidelines, right? So it tells you exactly how much flour you need, how much sugar, and other ingredients to use, and the steps to follow to ensure your cake will turn out well. So validation guidelines similarly specify how to examine HAI data in order to identify any errors or missing information. So this is the simplest way I can explain the validation guideline. The contents of my presentation, so introduction, the purpose, the principles, components, the categories by type, and the benefits. Also, the validation process, the challenges and barriers, and how to address these challenges and barriers. As per my learning objectives, so at the end of the presentation, the trainees will be able to know the importance of HAI data validation, implement the validation process accordingly, identify the different challenges and barriers, and find solutions to address the validation challenges and barriers. So healthcare-associated infection, or HAI, surveillance validation guidelines, they are a set of standards and procedures that can be used to assess the accuracy and completeness of HAI surveillance data. These guidelines are important. Why? Because they ensure that the infection prevention priorities are set correctly and the progress is accurately measured. So validation, it means checking the data meets predetermined specifications and quality standards. What is the purpose of this validation guideline? So HAI surveillance validation, it aims to ensure a systemic validation process to ensure accurate and reliable collected data for monitoring and preventing HAIs. Who is responsible for doing the validation? So GDIP surveillance coordinators, regional surveillance coordinators, cluster surveillance coordinators, and even the hospital surveillance coordinators in all healthcare sectors. For the general principles, validation should be conducted regularly. This will help to ensure that HAI surveillance data is consistently accurate and reliable. Validation should be conducted by trained and expert personnel, and this will help to ensure that validation activities are conducted effectively. Also, validation should be focused on the surveillance process to help avoid bias in the validation of results. What are the key components of HAI surveillance validation guidelines? One is visit. Visit, it can be on-site visit, to the targeted hospitals for validation. Data review, another component. This one you have to review as a valid, the one as an auditor, you have to review medical files, records, lab records. You have also to do interview, staff interview, in order to ensure accurate identification of HAIs. Third component is feedback and recommendation. So feedback and recommendation involves providing feedback to healthcare staff on the result of the validation. Another component is follow-up. So how we will do the follow-up? By arranging meetings with relevant stakeholders in order to discuss the results and to allow further clarification. So our last component is to conduct post follow-up evaluation. So once the follow-up actions have been completed, so you must evaluate the effectiveness of the measures taken. So these are the key components of HAI surveillance data validation guidelines. There are categories by type of validation. It could be internal and external. So when we say internal validation, it means active effort by a reporting facility in order to assure completeness and accuracy of data. When we say external validation, these are like survey or audit process by an external coordinator in order to ensure that the quality of surveillance data, to ensure the quality of surveillance data and quality of reporting. So it's by two types, internal validation and external validation. So what are the benefits of internal and external validation? One is to improve accuracy and completeness of data. The second is to enhance quality of IPC programs. Third is to increase the transparency and accountability. Fourth, the impact on HAI rate reduction and provide recommendations for improvement. So we'll go to the validation process. The meaning of the HAI surveillance validation process, it boils down to ensuring the reliability and trustworthiness of data collected on HAIs. The specific process can vary depending on the healthcare setting and national guidelines. Different types of validation methods exist. So such as chart review and electronic data analysis. Also, regular validation helps maintain data integrity and informs continuous improvement in HAI prevention efforts. There are different roles of coordinators in HESEN Plus data entry. So there is one for hospital surveillance coordinator, another for cluster surveillance coordinator, and another one for the regional surveillance coordinator. So we'll start with the regional surveillance coordinator. So regional surveillance coordinator, what are their roles in validation, data validation? So one is to monitor the hospital HAI surveillance data in the HESEN dashboard daily. Also, they need to review the validated data submitted by the cluster coordinator. Another is to compare the actual number of patients in the ICU and the total number of patients entered in the HESEN Plus. If the data entry in HESEN Plus does not match the actual number, they have to contact the cluster surveillance coordinator and ask for action. And then share with GDIPC surveillance team the data validated per hospital in the region. So follow up with the cluster coordinators for improvement also in data entry. So these are the roles for regional surveillance coordinators. So another one is cluster surveillance coordinator. What are their roles? So they have to monitor the hospital HAI surveillance data entry in the HESEN Plus daily. So it is same with regional coordinators. They have to check it daily. Then they have to review the data entry and compare to compare the actual number of patients, for example, today in the ICU, and the actual total number of patients entered in HESEN Plus today also. So share with the regional surveillance coordinator the data validated per hospital in your region and the actions taken. If it's not the same number, so means they need to update or enter the data. Then follow up with the hospital coordinators for improvement in data entry. Also, there is a role for a hospital surveillance coordinator. So they need to review the actual number of patients in the ICU daily at a regular time. So if they used to go at 10 a.m., so they must do it regularly at the same time. Enter the data of all ICU admitted patients in HESEN Plus, including the devices, the events, and the bundles. So it has to be updated daily. If not possible to enter patients in HESEN on time, this is for the hospital, okay, coordinator. So data entry of ICU patients must be done before the end of the shift. Okay. Is it clear, the roles of coordinators? So this is conditional validation visit process. The first thing to do is to review the hospital HAI surveillance data. Then, if does the hospital have zero reporting or high HAI rates? If no, there is no zero reporting or there is no high HAI rates, what to do? There is no need for any conditional validation visit. If yes, for how long? Maybe 1 month, 2 months, or 3 months. If 1 month, the hospital have zero reporting or high HAI rates, what they should do? The cluster coordinator will review the submitted data, including the previous months. Cluster coordinator will call the hospital surveillance coordinator and ask the reasons behind high HAI rates or zero reporting. Then request for any action plan. Also ask advice on give advice on proper implementation of prevention tools to CLABSI, CAUTI, and other HAI. Also, they have to provide the education and training sessions as needed. And then do the follow-up of implementation of the plan. This is conditional validation visit process. So that is for the only 1 month. There is zero reporting and there is high HAI rates. So if it's 2 months, the regional and cluster coordinator, this is the responsibility of regional and cluster coordinator. The same process. So start by reviewing the surveillance data. Then if it's zero reporting or high HAI rates for 2 months, they have to follow the role of regional and cluster coordinator. if there is no zero reporting or high HAI rates, so no conditional validation visit needed. The same process. So what are the roles of regional and cluster coordination if there are, if there are zero reporting or high HAI rates for 2 months? So the regional and cluster coordinator will visit the healthcare facility. They have to conduct root cause analysis. So they have to know why and to find solution. Then they have to request for a corrective action plan. Also check for the implementation of the prevention tools for cloud, CE, county, and other HAIs. And then if needed, they have to conduct on-site short education and training sessions. And then as the regional coordinator, she must submit summary report to GTIPC together with the cluster coordination. And then they have to continuously monitor the implementation of the corrective action plan. So this is clear, this is for 2 months if there is zero reporting or high HAI rates. What about if it's 3 months? Who is the one responsible? It will be from us, GTIPC Surveillance Coordinator. So what we will do, we have to contact the regional coordinator, arrange a visit to the healthcare facility if required. Then during the visit, we have to check and review the line list of ICU patients with positive cultures, check the compliance with HAI bundles, check the implementation of prevention tools, compliance to clubs, county, and other HAIs. And also we can conduct meetings with the IPC department, regional and cluster coordinator, and healthcare facility leaders. And then we will prepare a summary report on the findings and share feedback to the region and follow up the implementation of the plan. That is for conditional validation visit. Now we'll go to routine validation visit process. So routine means monthly. So review monthly submitted data manually. Then review the data entry in HESEN Plus. Then compare the data from HESEN and the data submitted manually, the SVT. Then compare the denominator data, which is the patient, which are the patient days, device days, number of surgeries, patients' months in dialysis, and so on. Compare between the manual and the HESEN data entry. So compare also the numerator data, so the number of CLABSIs, number of events, CLABSI, CAUTI, VAE, SSI, or dialysis events. Then, if there are more than 5% difference between manual and HESEN Plus data entry, so if no, there is no further validation process to be done. If yes, so contact the cluster or hospital infection control director. Then identify the issues related to HAI surveillance data entry and reporting in HESEN Plus. So how you will identify the surveillance process, check up the availability of updated surveillance manual and educational materials, and any need for training on HESEN Plus, maybe they are not well trained, identify any technical challenges. So a lot of issues in HESEN Plus. Identify any causes of low compliance in data entry and ask for corrective plan, action plan, and monitor the improvement. And then there must be continuous follow-up with hospitals in order to improve data entry. Do routine validation visit to hospitals at least each quarter of the year. So it means quarterly. So this is for routine validation visit. Quarterly, and make report and provide feedback to the concerned hospitals. So when you do routine validation visit in the hospitals, so the same, they have to identify the issues related to HAI surveillance data entry and reporting in HESAN Plus. So the same process. And this one, it must be submitted as a summary report every 25th of the month after the quarter to us, to GDIPC surveillance program. So for example, first quarter, January to March. So submit, it must be submitted on the 25th, on or before the 25th of April. And then regular follow-up with hospitals in order to improve data entry. So this is for routine validation visit process. It must be done monthly. So what you will do in during on-site validation? So you need to validate the HAIs, CLABSI, CAUTI, VAE, MDRO. First is to prepare for validation. So how you will prepare for validation? You have to ask client list from the hospital surveillance coordinator. So you have to call them and ask and prepare a line list. And then you have to select 20 random patients with positive cultures. This is from the line list, okay? Then review including the events. So from the 20, it is including the events, identified events, whatever events. And then you have to evaluate if HAI or event is identified or missed according to CDC or NHS and definitions and criteria. After that, you have to complete the surveillance validation reporting form. This is, I will show you later on how to fill the surveillance validation reporting form. And then prepare a summary report and submit the report with recommendations. Request for action plan for improvement if needed, and then for follow-up, schedule meetings with the concerned region or hospital in order to discuss the implementation of the plan. So this is during on-site validation. On-site means you have to be there in the hospital or in the region when you do the validation. You have to be in the hospital on-site with the regional coordinator or cluster coordinator. So this is regarding, before it was regarding CLABSI, CAUTI, VAE, and MDRO. And there is also a way to validate during on-site about surgical site infection. So on-site validation process for surgical site infection. So what to do? The same process, prepare for validation, line list prepared by hospital surveillance coordinator. Because the line list for CAUTI, CLABSI, VEE, and MDRO, it's not the same for surgical site infection line list. Because this is for operative procedures. And then identify the total number of patients who had the selected operative procedures in the period requested. For example, first quarter, January to March. And selected operative procedure in one hospital is appendectomy. So you have to validate only the appendectomy patients from January to March. Okay? And then in the line list of patients post-operative appendectomy, so you have to select 20 patients to review in order, including the identify SSI events, if there is, during the first quarter, for example. So 20 patients, same as CLABSI, CAUTI, and MDRO-VE process. So this one, 20 patients applicable if the hospital is more than 100 bed capacities, or if they have at least more than 10, 20 beds in ICU. Surgical site. If more than 100 surgeries or more than 100 surgeries per month can be 20 patients. But if you do it quarterly, even 50 could be 50 surgeries per month. Then do a retrospective data review of the selected 20 patients. So retrospective means from the previous, because some patients already discharged and you have to do this one to check for the medical records file of the patient. And then evaluate if HAI was identified on or within 30 or 90 days post-operative procedure. Depends on which procedure they have selected in the hospital. And according to CDC, NHS, and definitions and criteria. Then they have to check for the SSI post-discharge surveillance process. So how the facility follows the patients after discharge to detect SSI. Then complete the surveillance validation reporting form and submit a summary report with recommendations and feedback to the concerned hospitals. So this is during on-site validation of surgical site infection. Another is about dialysis event. How we are going to validate dialysis events. Okay, so same, prepare for validation. Check for the line list as prepared by the dialysis event surveillance coordinator in the center. Then identify the total number of patients who came for dialysis during the first and second working days of the month. Then randomly select 20 patients to review, including the identified events. Evaluate if the dialysis event was identified correctly according to CDC or NHS and definitions and criteria. Then complete the validation reporting for dialysis event surveillance for patients who had an event. Then submit a summary report with recommendations and feedback to the concerned center. Another one to check during validation visit is the compliance with HAI prevention tools. So also as to prepare for validation. So all HAI prevention tools compliance rates must be prepared in a file for review and separated for each type of HAI. So like CLABSI, CAUTI, VE, SSI, MDRO, and DE. They all have separate compliance to prevention, HAI prevention tools. They have their own. So you review the compliance rates accordingly per type of HAI. And then correlate the compliance rates with the corresponding HAI rates. So compare the rates, if it's high or low, and the compliance to the tools per each module or per each type of HAI. Then if there are gaps or barriers to compliance, like lack of resources or staff resistance, address them promptly. So provide additional training, resources, or support to overcome these challenges and improve the compliance rates. So speaking of challenges and barriers, so there are challenges in HAI surveillance validation data validation. One is resource constraints. It means limited time and personnel dedicated to do the validation. Another is data accessibility and quality. There might be inconsistent data collection practices across hospitals, so there must be incomplete or missing data. Another challenge is expertise and training. So lack of standardized training on HAI validation methodologies. Another one is communication and collaboration. So that is, there might be lack of clear communication channels that can hinder data collection and feedback. So these are the challenges. What about the barriers? So one barrier is resistance from hospital staff. So it's a big barrier because there is fear of increased workload and potential negative performance implications. So how are we going to address the challenges and barriers? So one is to allocate dedicated personnel for HAI surveillance validation. So we must allocate one dedicated personnel. Another is standardized protocols, data collection methods, and training for surveillance coordinators can improve consistency and accuracy. Another is to improve the communication channels, give feedback, collaborate partnerships, and that can address resistance and enhance cooperation. Another one is to encourage data entry by electronic system or HESEN Plus. And lastly, always provide feedback and support. As for the conclusion of my presentation, the validation guidelines of HAI surveillance can provide a comprehensive framework, as what I have said, for ensuring accuracy and reliability of surveillance systems in monitoring healthcare-associated infections. So these guidelines emphasize the importance of intensive validation processes, which includes data collection, analysis, and reporting in order to ensure that surveillance systems effectively identify and track healthcare-associated infections. So by adhering to these guidelines, healthcare facilities can enhance patient safety, improve infection control practices, and ultimately reduce the incidence of HAIs. I have a quote here regarding validation. It says, "Validation is the key to data integrity." It is by Edward Deming. So what does it mean? Validation is the key to data integrity. So this is an excellent quote that captures the essence of HAI surveillance. It is concise, easy to memorize, and directly addresses the importance of data validation. So it conveys a message that without validation efforts, data integrity in healthcare-associated infection surveillance crumbles. It falls. So this in turn can lead to inaccurate infection rates, misplaced resources, and ultimately compromised patient safety. Okay, that's it for my presentation today. Now we'll go to the question and answer. If you have any questions, you can ask me now. I need to show to you, okay, before that, I will show to you the validation reporting form. I will share with you, okay?
Okay, Sual. المحاضرة راح ننزلها لكم الآن إن شاء الله. بس إذا في أي سؤال. Okay, you will explain this.
Yes, after this class, if you have any question, I will. Sure. So this is the Okay, I'll hide it. So this is our validation reporting form. It is available in our GTIPC website under our surveillance department in the tools. So what is inside the validation reporting form? First, there is instruction. Okay, for the instruction, it is for the regional surveillance coordinator, cluster coordinator, or dialysis event coordinator, because it's separate coordinator for dialysis. So this form is to be filled only during on-site hospital visit as documentation of validated data. Then second, review the line list for the period requested. For example, you asked for first quarter, so January to March. You asked for the line list January to March to the hospital surveillance coordinator. So review the line list for the period requested to the hospital surveillance coordinator. And then do random review around 20 patients from the line list, including all with recorded events. So from that 20 patients, even those who have events, add to that 20. So if there are 3 events in that hospital, so add, you will take 17 with positive culture, and then plus the 3 events. So you have to review the 20. If it's a big number of patients in the hospital, like more than 20 beds or more than 10 beds in ICU. But if it's less number of beds, can be lesser than 20, review on 10 or less. If it's less number of beds, less than 20 beds or less than 10 beds. And then analyze the data in the line list, fill the validation reporting form, and provide feedback by making a summary report and share to the concerned hospitals. And then share to GTIPC surveillance program the summary report and attach the validation reporting form. So there is a sheet for validation report for HAI, validation report for dialysis event, and validation report for SSI. So we go to the validation report for HAI. What is inside the validation reporting form? It is an Excel sheet. There is the region, the hospital, and the date. And then the instruction, randomly choose to validate 20 from the line list, including the identified events, and check all that applies to the data related to the question below, and specify the type of event from the drop-down list. So there is here SN, the serial number, the month, MRN or ID of the patient, the name of the patient, the age, gender, the ICU admission date of positive culture, the unit where specimen was collected. Because sometimes they're taking the specimen from emergency room. So our target area is ICU, for example, medical surgical ICU. And then date of specimen collection, type of specimen could be urine, blood, wound, and so on. So that is this Q1, means question one. Was event reported as HAI? Choose yes or no. So this one, if there is an event in the hospital and they reported it as HAI, so you click yes. So if not, there was no event. If the question one answer is no, complete the following data. Okay, here. No device more than 2 days or no device in place at the time of the event. You just check. Then present on admission and not discharged in previous 2 days. Maybe does not meet the criteria but met the exclusion criteria. Or there must be single blood contamination, 2 blood samples, but no signs and symptoms. Secondary BSI, not primary site infection, or missed and should have been reported. So all these, those positive cultures, you have to check. Okay, if there it is missed and should have been reported, you check it. So if the answer is yes, this is if the answer is no, all these questions. If the answer is yes in question one, so was event reported as HAI, yes or no? If the answer is yes, specify the type of HAI event. So is it MDRO, yes or no? MDRO means multi-drug resistant organism. So if there is if it's MDRO, for example, you have to specify the organism. If the answer in question one is yes, again, if it's still yes, there is event was reported in error and not as CLABSI or CLABSI or VAE, because sometimes it is reported as CLABSI, but it's not supposed to be reported. Maybe it's not CLABSI, maybe CLABSI, maybe it's primary infection for CLABSI, not as CLABSI. So if the answer to question one is yes, again, so I put color coded here. So green, if the answer is yes or no. Yes, if yellow, if the answer is no. So if the answer is yes, an event was reported correctly, you have to check. And then write any comments to support your answer. So this is after you validate the 20 random patients. So you will write all the patients you need to evaluate or to validate. So this one, in the hospital, they will give you the list, okay, the line list. And as the one who will validate, you are from regional infection control coordinator or cluster coordinator. So you have to check the records of the patient and see if it's correctly identified HAI or not. So these questions for yes, no, questions to be answered will support the answer, the validation process. Okay, is it clear? About the dialysis event, there is another. I think they created a form for the dialysis event, not this one. So maybe Dr. Muhammad, he will explain about he explained already about the dialysis event. There is another form for this. And then validation report for SSI. So the same way, you have to choose 20 patients. So what is added here? So the date of operative procedure and the type of operative procedure. Each hospital, we ask them to choose one procedure, one or two procedures that is high volume and high risk procedure. So accordingly to that procedure, they have to choose the 20 patients. For example, they choose appendectomy or CABG. So they would only put all CABG patients. And then the questions depends on the SSI, only for the signs and symptoms, if there is, just specify. And then if SSI event identified, yes or no. Then if the answer is no, the event identified within 30 days or 90 days post-operatively and according to CDC criteria and definitions. Because it depends on the type of surgery or operative procedure. It could be the surveillance, period of surveillance is within 30 days or could be within 90 days. If the answer in question one is yes, but the event was reported by mistake, check. And if the answer to question is yes, an event was reported correctly, check. So it is much simpler than the validation process for HAI, like CLABS, CAUTI, VAE. Okay, is it clear? You have any question? Okay, do you have any question? Yes, Mishai.
How are you, Eva?
Yes, sure. Oh, you're here, okay.
The same questions for Mishari.
Okay.
For example, if I have 100 bid, the quantity, the patient 20, I take the 20 patient, or we have a rule about that?
Okay, according to the number of beds in the ICU, for example, they have 100 beds, but the ICU beds may be less. So 20 okay. bed, 20 patients, if it's, because you will take it, the validation process will not be only for just 1 month. Usually we do it quarterly. So if it's necessary, only they will do the validation for 1 month, 2 months, if there is high rates and like that. But that's why it can take 20 patients randomly. If it's 3 months, they request it. If it's 1 month, so with the events reported, identified, plus according to the total number of patients per month. So if it's not more than 20, of course you will not take 20. You take only 5 or 10, like that.
If the bid of the ICU less than 20, I take it less than 20 patient, any 5 patient or 6 patient, like that.
Yes, if it's also not only by the beds, also by the total number of patients admitted in ICU. If it's less,
okay, thank you.
Maybe they have less number of beds, but they have a lot of admissions. Like it's always full per day, so yeah, it depends on the
day. Okay, and it depends of the admitted patient duration in 3 months.
Yes.
And after 3 months, okay, thank you.
Yes, okay, welcome. Yeah, any more question? Is it clear to all of you the validation process? Still, we have time because I finished early. So it's clear, you don't have any more questions? Okay, Abrar?